last week at the team today. Not a guy that maybe we've never thought of as a vocal leader. How did he do? What did he say?
Chris did excellent. He really did an excellent job, especially since I just told him right at the end of walkthrough. I said, you know, you're one of those guys that you don't speak much. I said, I can't remember in recent past when I've had you speak. He said, well, whenever I'm asked, I'll do it. And I said, well, you're doing it today. And he did a great job, you know, and he just complimented the team and the way they work. And, you know, and he just talked about himself and the way that he prepares and the way that, you know, he's, you know, rose to the level where he is today.
What is the thinking of putting Corey Williams?
Well, you know, it's one of those things to where we have a lot of young guys that we need to see. And then also, you know, with the past incident, you know, there's still some terms and conditions being held there. And then it just gives him an opportunity to see what he can do. You know, he's a young guy. He's played in this league. And, you know, there's some things that we can do offensively with him. But, you know, got to get his feet wet and see where we go with that.
Is that also part of the Chaz Chillen's performance was what you made?
It was more so just about some of the things that we're trying to do within the offense. You know, Chaz, to me, he's – when I look at Chaz, to be honest with you, and I told him this the other day, he reminds me of Taj in the first year to where, you know, I can remember when we first started out, there was a couple other guys we had ahead of Taj, but, you know, we believed that he would catch on, and eventually he did, and he's one of the top players in this league. So, you know, we asked those guys to do a lot early, and every time a new guy steps in there, they're a little brain cramped because it's the CFL when they haven't had experience. So. No, go ahead.
Is this the end of the discipline for Taj, or will there still be more ramifications?
Well, you know, there's always ramifications, but it's just as far as on the field, you know, that's probably where it goes, you know. As it goes, like if Williams has a lights out game, then maybe he holds that spot, you know. But right now, it's that's where we are, and then we'll, once this is over, we'll move forward from there.
Can you talk to Taj this week, like, progressing through this? You know, we talked so much about the family aspect of it. Have you had a chance to guide him along?
No, you know, once we spoke, I think early in the week, it was on an off day. Then since then, you know, we haven't talked about it. It's been football. It's been all about football. He knows, you know, it's not like I'm dealing with eight-year-olds. He knows exactly what he's done and what he has to do to get to where he wants to be as a professional and as a person.
Corey, have you had to talk to this team this week about being overconfident at all or not?
No. We talked about just making sure we don't, you know, read all the blogs, read all the guarantees that's out there and all those good things that allows us to get unfocused. It's a football game and we have to move forward and work to win.
Which blogs are these?
There's a couple of guys local that says a guaranteed victory. There's no such thing as a guaranteed victory. You have to work for four quarters, sometimes more.
I don't think you read the blogs.
Say it again?
I don't think you read the blog when I lose.
No, it's just RP just shows me most of the stuff that I have to look at. So it's all those famous guys.
You have Jerome Messon facing his former team with that kind of baggage and more court. Is that going to come into play how you use the two running backs?
You know, the only thing I told Jerome when I spoke to him is, hey, this is your old team. I don't see anything silly. You know, but there's a lot of guys that's played for him, you know. Just move forward. You're doing a good job. Continue to do what you do. Don't play someone else's game. Play our game.
Could you see Jerome having the type of game against a more traditional defense of Montreal than against one of the smaller guys?
You know, he's a good back, and he's done some things in this league. You know, so I think, you know, however it shakes down between he and Will, you know, the biggest key is it's not just about the individual. It's about, you know, if we come out there with the yards we need run game-wise to sustain some drive and do different things like that.
Has it gotten to the point with the running game where it's – what you see from the other defense will decide in the game who you're going to send out there?
I think it's probably leaning toward that, you know, and sometimes it's just, you know, the luck of the draw with those guys on, you know, who's tired, who hits the hole better and all those things. But they're both working well together. And like I said, sometimes it is just some schemes don't match up against some of those backs. And I think that's a good luxury.
Thank you.